Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll be going to explain you radar range equation. Here I'll be deriving radar range equation step by step. So as I have explained you in my earlier videos, radar that is used to identify unknown objects. Here our agenda is to identify range of radar for unknown objects. You can observe here radar system that is connected with transceiver antenna. Here, this antenna will be transmitting EM waves in the space. You can observe this antenna that is transmitting EM waves in the space. By this color, we have transmitted EM waves. Once those EM waves that is striking on this object, there will be reflected EM waves. So you can observe by red color, I am showing you reflected EM waves. Once reflected EM waves that is coming on this radar, radar can identify range of the object, right? So here, first of all, you need to understand, see this transreceiving system, which is there with radar, that is transmitting high power. Let us assume here transmitted power by antenna is PT. And usually that will be there in terms of kilowatts to megawatts, right? So here, transmitting antenna, that is transmitting very high power, let us assume that is PT. Now, first of all, what I'll do is I'll be considering isotropic source. So instead of this antenna, if I explain you these things in terms of isotropic source, then it will be a bit more clear to you. So let us assume we have isotropic source over here. So as if you have isotropic source at center over here, then at distance r, then at distance r, what will be power density over here? Power density, that will be transmitted power divided by 4 pi r square. Why? The reason is area at distance r for sphere, that is 4 pi r square. Isotropic source radiates equally in all the direction. So power density at distance r, that is power divided by that spherical area, right? So you will be having power density for isotropic source, that is PT divided by 4 pi r square. But here in the radar system, we don't use isotropic source, right? In the radar system, we use this antenna. So as if I say this antenna that is having gain G towards the object. Here you see we have object. And if I say this antenna that is having gain G towards the object, then with this antenna, what is power density? That is power density of isotropic source into gain G, right? Power density will be PT into G divided by 4 pi r square, right? So this is what power density that is happening in this direction at distance r. Now you see this object that is coming into the picture. Now see this power density that is coming here at object, and as if object cross section area, that is sigma, then how much power that is coming on object? That is power density into area of object, right? Power coming on object, that is power density at object into area of object. Here sigma is area of object. So now PTG sigma by 4 pi r square, that much power that is reflected on this object, right? Now after reflection, we have reflected EM waves that you can observe, right? Now see, object is not having specific shape, right? It can radiate randomly. So random radiation, that is considered as a isotropic radiation. So whatever power that is striking on the object, that is radiated equally in all the direction. So here, as per the explanation of isotropic source, whatever power that is coming over here, that is getting radiated over here, right? And now what will be power density of reflected wave at antenna? So here we have calculated power on the object, that is PTG sigma by 4 pi r square, right? But now here power density at radar after reflected wave, that is how much power over here divided by area at distance r. So area at distance r is 4 pi r square. So 4 pi r square that you need to divide with this to get power density of reflected wave, right? So power density of reflected wave at radar, that is this divided by 4 pi r square. So in denominator we will be having 4 pi r square whole square, right? So now we have power density of reflected wave at radar, right? So by red color, now we have power density at radar. Now see, if I say with radar antenna effective area is AE, then how much reflected power that will be received over here? Power density into effective area, right? So if I say this antenna is having effective area AE, then received power that will be this into AE. If I say received power is PR, then that will be this into effective area AE. So that will be PTG sigma AE divided by 4 pi r square whole square, right? Now we have received power by radar, right? And what we wanted to have? We wanted to have maximum range of radar. So if you want to calculate maximum range of radar, then here you will have to consider minimum received signal, right? The reason is, see, based on receiver system of radar, one should know limit of the radar up to which it can receive the signal, right? It cannot receive signal beyond some limit, right? So if I say we have maximum range of radar, then received signal will be minimum acceptable signal, right? So for maximum range of radar, R is equals to R max. At that time, this received signal, that will be minimum acceptable signal S min, right? So now your equation that is getting converted in form of S min and R max. So PR that is equals to S min, that is equals to PTG sigma AE divided by 4 pi square into R max raised to 4 over here. Now our agenda is to identify maximum range of radar. So let us have R max, that is main term over here. So you will have to divide this over here. So R max will be PT G sigma A divided by 4 pi square S min, right? And here R raised to 4 is there. So with this, you will be having raised to 1 by 4. So that is what? Radar range equation, right? This is radar range equation. Now with this radar range equation, see, usually we will be using parabolic dish antenna, right? If you have parabolic dish antenna, then one should know the gain of parabolic dish antenna, that is 4 pi a by lambda square. And if you substitute the value of gain in this equation, then our radar range equation that is getting modified. Now you see, if you place this over here, then 1 4 pi that is getting cancelled, and AE that will be getting squared in numerator, right? So PT sigma AE square will be there, and in denominator 4 pi that is getting cancelled, and will be having lambda square into S min into 4 pi. So that is what radar range equation, right? And this radar range equation that explains you maximum range of radar, where S min, that is minimum acceptable signal by radar over here, right? This equation is very essential. Based on this equation, one can identify what is the maximum range of radar system. And based on this equation, in future, I'll be solving some examples even. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you'd like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.